Hello again. We will now be discovering LEM simulations step by step. In Akabak, simulations are made with components. They are the elements that constitute any project, and their goal is to allow us to describe to the software the shapes and properties of the cabinet that we want to simulate. Components can be configured and connected together to form networks, thus telling the software how they interact with each other. For example, the front face of the speaker component can be connected to the horn component to indicate the presence of a horn in front of the speaker. And if the horn has a complex shape, a single horn component is not enough to precisely describe its shape, and we will need to break it down into multiple horns components connected together. Let's now see in Akabak how to use the components. Open the LEM site page as well as the LEM editor. Then click on the new component speed button. Make sure to have the LEM component tab opened, and from there, click on a category and either drag a component or double-click on it to place it in the interface. When a component is selected, it is shown in red, and in the left side page, a list of values appears. This is where the physical properties of the components are set. This editor is in fact a schematic editor, which means that you can freely move around the components and connect them together with wires to form networks. To connect components, place your mouse over one of its outgoing branches, that is called a pole, click and drag your mouse around. When multiple components are connected together, nodes form at the points where the wires are joined. Similarly, two wires can cross without being linked, and the lack of nodes at the intersection will help you tell the difference. Let's now have an in-depth view of the way components connect together. The pole of the components, although looking all identical, actually belong to different domains. For example, the LEDIN driver, which is the speaker component, have four poles. The two on the left are dedicated to the electrical connection of the speaker, while the two on the right are in the acoustic domain and correspond to the acoustic output of the front and the rear side of the diaphragm. There are in total three domains in the LEM editor: mechanical, acoustical, and electrical. You can see these three domains as three independent planes in a single interface. Some components behave on one plane, like the horn that has an acoustic input and an acoustic output, while a few others, like the speaker, works on two planes, converting the electrical signal into an acoustical signal. If you try to connect together poles from different domains, at first sight nothing will happen and the editor won't prevent you to do so. However, when Akabak will try to solve the network, you're likely to get blank results because the time-related signal couldn't go through a component of a different domain.